In the French capital, evidence of wealth and privilege is abundant. Paris ranks as one of the world's most expensive cities to live in. But just a few kilometers away, across a motorway that some say is a border between two worlds, are the banlieues, suburbs where the French value of égalité, or equality, doesn't run deep.
Faire valoir le droit des habitants ou le droit des locataires.
My guide to understand the complexities of the problems here is Fouad Ben Ahmad, a community organizer who grew up in Bobigny, one of the toughest Parisian suburbs.
On voit que certains membres du gouvernement.
We see a certain reality on the part of the government, those who are in jobs that could really change the lives of those who live here. They can't come to understand the reality the people are facing. That's really tough.
Ben Ahmad drives me around what's known as the 93, a department to the north of Paris that is home to some of France's poorest and most disenfranchised residents. Within the 93, there are the cités, public housing projects that have become the symbol of racial and economic segregation.
Exclusion begins when you don't have work, when you can't access transportation, when you can't enjoy all your rights completely, not being able to send your CV to a company without account for the fact that you're sending it from the 93. The exclusion here is the combination of many factors, and when people are excluded, they don't want to belong anymore.
We visit Clichy-sous-Bois, which gained the world's attention in 2005 during 3 weeks of violent social unrest.
It doesn't work. We just saw a woman who's going up 10 stories by foot. Mobility starts at your front door, and when you can't access your own house or can't go outside, it's catastrophic.
There's this sort of racial barrier that's built up. Despite being the country of human rights, with the Declaration of Rights of Man, rule of law, democracy, etc., it's still way more complicated to find a job when your name is Boubacar and you're of Malian origin than when your name is Bernard and your parents were born in Brittany. It's a country of equality on paper, but it's a country of inequality and injustice in reality.
Since 2005, the French government has spent over 50 billion euros, hoping to improve these neighborhoods. But very few argue that anything has changed. In Seine-Saint-Denis, Ryan Thompson, Euronews.